Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for an early morning Raw preview. Brock Lesnar is supposed to be there tomorrow night, and it's about goddamn time there. Weeks and weeks of bad ratings. Fuck all happening apart from the Samoa Joe stuff from recently. It's been a stretch of bad shows for a little while there. Ratings fucking crumbling. No champion, you know. It's about fucking time that Lesnar shows up. Hopefully they're going to do something good. Don't just bring him out, make him stand like this there. Have him do something, a big brawl, or the fans deserve something there. You know, a 3-hour show, we need some entertainment in the fucking shows there. But nowadays, it's all about half-assing it, I guess. There, here's 2.5 hours of random shit and 15 minutes of decent stuff, but, you know, if they keep going like this, fuck, who knows how low it's going to get there. But I'm happy that Brock is going to be there, so there's something to look forward to on the show. We're getting a Hardys versus Cesaro and Sheamus rematch. You know, it's a little something, I guess. A little something there, so it'll probably end in some kind of fuck finish DQ with a 50th match at Great Balls of Fire in the month or something there. Who is Enzo and Cass's attacker? God knows, man. Most people think it's Cass. It might turn out to be somebody else that's going to play mind games with them, and they're going to split up. Either way, just fucking split up and move on there. What they should have done with these guys is actually give them the tag belts before splitting them up. People thought they were the second coming of the New Age Outlaws at the beginning, shit like this. And people lost interest because they just had them jobbing all the time. They never got to win the belts. So I guess it looks like they'll just split them up and start using Big Cass as a singles guy because he's big. I don't know. Might need a little bit of roids or something there to get a little physique going. Who knows how far he's going to get. Can Alexa Bliss evade Nia Jax's fury? I'll take care. Alexa Bliss, she can come hide out at my place. Come on. Is Bray Wyatt coming for the King Slayer? I guess so. They need to have that boring Rollins feud every week there, or every month or whatever. And just this whole King Slayer shit there. I'm sure Triple H's ego loves this gimmick. Oh, he loves that, you know, Rollins calls himself the King Slayer, and this whole gimmick is because he beat Triple H. Triple H's ego must enjoy this, but I don't think nobody else does. This King Slayer is just a boring, watered down version of Seth Rollins with nothing, no excitement, absolutely nothing. What is this King Slayer garbage? Just turn him heel again there. When he first came back from injury, the crowd was freaking out for him. They could have turned him face there. He had momentum, you know, but they waited a while, and then he became a face when nobody gave a shit anymore, and now it's just boring, the Seth Rollins stuff at this point there. Well, Dean Ambrose strike again. Probably a hit and miss there. Strike one. Oh, let's try to do something good here, Dean. Try to entertain the crowd. Strike two. Oh, how about some of that Dean Ambrose comedy? Strike three. You're out. You're boring. Get the fuck out with your corny garbage there. I think Miz needs to be separated from Ambrose once and for all there. Let Miz be the Miz, this whole thing where Miz gets buried by Ambrose every week there. It's kind of getting lame there. Let Ambrose get over on somebody else's behalf there. That's the thing. Ambrose, he's boring right now. It's not clicking like it used to. At some point in time, it looked like he was going to become a star. He became the champ, and it just went downhill. The excitement for Ambrose just went downhill. Let the Miz shine there. Let Miz do some good stuff. We don't need to bury Miz all the time just to put over Ambrose, who's on the decline there. Fuck off, you boring motherfucker. Move the fuck on there. So yeah, there's Raw, folks. I'm pissed off before this shit even gets underway there, but hopefully it's going to be a better show tomorrow night there. Hopefully it's not what they do with Lesnar a lot of times. You're going to get a shitty, crappy, boring show, and then they bring out Lesnar at the end. Oh my God, the vibe has just changed there. That's what they do all the time. So hopefully it's not 3 hours of pure torture garbage with 5 minutes of dancing Lesnar at the end there. Start giving us entertainment, you fucking retards. Until next time, peace.